So I'm going to start off with the lighter colors. I'm not going to get too crazy with the coloring. I'm just going to try to keep simple colors. For time restraints, because you can only watch somebody draw or paint for so long. And the nice thing about this is it's supposed to be a drawing challenge. So if I mess up, then I just didn't do that well on the challenge. And I can always work with it after the video's done. I can't go too incredibly heavy with the paints because I'm only painting on paper. Boy, that red is really bright on the screen. It's not that bright in person. Now, if you're Marvel fans and you were watching the Daredevil series on Netflix, I don't know if you watch any of the Netflix shows, but it was just announced that the second season of The Punisher is coming up on the 17th of January. I'm going to have to use a smaller brush for that area. Yeah, perfect. And I gave him quite a bit of a brow line, didn't I? Oh boy, does that lip look wonky. I'll work on it later. Get a little bit of red reflection under the jaw. Oh, there we go. Looks like my pencils might be blending in with my paints because it's my red in person. My red is kind of a muddy red. I don't draw Daredevil very often. Just not the biggest fan of him. Nothing really against him. It's just a I was more into reading X-Men and Fantastic Four, Spider-Man, Avengers. And then, of course, Gru the Wanderer, but he doesn't really fit into the superhero category. He barely fits into a hero category. Now, I have done other videos that weren't related to the Stan Lee tribute, and you can find them on YouTube. Just look up either Jason Nuttall or Nuttall Art. I can't remember what it's under. Because I know I did a, let me see, Popeye picture, of course. I think I did a Gru, but I can't remember. Did one of the Thing. And some of the Stanuary sketches I didn't do video of. But you can find the photos on Facebook. I'm on the Nuttall Art Facebook page or my Instagram or on my Twitter. Boy, howdy, that is some bright red on that screen, isn't it? I will say, doing this video, when I look at the screen, you don't see as many mistakes as you see in live, in person. So I'm kind of pretty happy about that. So, you know, according to you guys, this looks great. Or not according, but from your point of view, this is looking pretty good. There we go. No mistakes whatsoever. You also can't see me crying. Oh my goodness. Acrylic paint's drying up. And normally when I'm working, I usually have either TV playing or music playing, but I don't know all the details about, you know, copyrights and stuff like that, so I'm not taking the chance. And I forgot to grab a paper towel. Okay, chat amongst yourselves. I gotta go get a paper towel. There, like I never left. All right. So let me get some of your opinions. Which, if you saw the movies and the TV series, which one did you like more? Did you like the TV series or the Ben Affleck movie? Because honestly, I actually liked the Ben Affleck movie. I wasn't the biggest fan of what, Bullseye. But other than that, I didn't mind it. Think people give Ben Affleck a little bit too much of a hard time. Yeah, see, I Michelle says Ben Affleck. I enjoyed the movie. I couldn't finish watching Elektra, the movie Elektra, that is. But I love the series, though. I think it's really well cast. Yeah, the movie Elektra was awesome, or the character from the movie, from the Daredevil movie. I was actually kind of bored with the Elektra from the series. But then again, I feel that too many movies and shows have way too much romance, and it just gets melodramatic. And the paint in areas is the paint in some of these areas are pretty sloppy, but I have a plan. It's weird, some of the reflections on the screen make it look like I didn't paint in areas. Now I just have to build up some of the some contrast. Oops. And always wash your brushes when you're not using them. All right, where am I? Here's the brush. Okay. No, I just realized I never painted or colored the artwork from the last hi Tom Luth. From the last video that I did. Of the Black Widow. Teaching, I have to I don't know why, but I always have to remind my students that when you're working with paint and paintbrushes and everything, you need to have a variety of sizes of brushes. For some reason, and this goes for any age, they try to do like small areas with big brushes, big brushes, or big areas with small brushes. I know it seems kind of a simple concept, but for some, I've seen kids try to paint with the smallest brushes, and they have an entire area to work in. Just doesn't make sense to me. I mean, I know I get carried away when I'm painting, and tend to just use the same brush everywhere, but I usually have like a small brush and a big brush available and use the same big brush and the same small brush. See, by adding the black, it adds what do you call it? Oh, me and my words. I've got a miserable memory. By adding the black, it helps the DD stand out more. Instead of just having red on red. Like with Daredevil's eyes up here, they just kind of disappear. Which for Daredevil works pretty well since he can't see anyways. And you know what? I haven't even bothered to see what tomorrow's challenge is. If you are an artist and was a fan of Marvel Comics or the Marvel movies, I strongly suggest you try do this challenge. It's great practice because you're doing at least one drawing every day. Try different styles too. Make it a little bit more interesting for yourself. Like yesterday was the challenge was with Magneto, and I decided to make Magneto a Smurf. I don't know why. It just popped in my head. I could see the blue nose sticking out of Magneto's helmet, and it made me giggle. So, granted, doesn't take much to make me giggle. But this is a, you know, slightly more traditional comic book style here. But then I also ventured off into, what do you call that? Archie Comics style for Black Widow on the third day. I love Archie Comics art, especially in the early days. Maybe not the original artwork from like the very beginning of Archie, but artists after that. I think Dan DiCarlo was one of them that I really liked. Lately, it's been the most recent that really caught my eye is Fernando Ruiz. I hope I'm saying his name correctly. And what I might also do is throughout the picture, eventually take a ink pen and bring in some of the fine lines. I'm not going for reality. I'm going more for comic book style here. Shoot, you know what, I was actually thinking of doing the original Daredevil costume, because that's when Stanley last worked on Daredevil, was back in those days. It was a horrible colored costume. It was red and yellow, mainly yellow. But I always get a kick out of, you know, the original designs. Another huge disadvantage of using painting on paper is the paper starts to warp. I'm gonna have to fix that. It's not too sharp of a change there in the neck. I know that the light reflection kind of takes over the picture a little bit on screen, but if I turned it off, then I'll be in complete darkness. I wish I had better brushes. I do have better brushes, but they're in another room, and I just don't feel like trying to search for them. Oh, where's my little brush? Yeah, I'll probably end up having to ink this as well. Ah, that eye looks so wonky. It's drawn better, but I can't. Than it is painted. know, I've had stuck in my head all day. I was listening to the radio, running errands with the kids. It stuck in my head the song Oh Sherry by Steve Perry. And I am hoping that now that I've mentioned that song, everybody who's listening, who knows that song, has it stuck in their head now. And since I don't know all the words, I only know like the main part, and I'm not even sure what those words are. It's kind of garbled. In the song. I've never been able to understand everything that he says in the lyrics. I'm trying to do minimal amount of colors with this piece. And yet I'm still taking almost an hour to do it. Took me less time to draw it out. Now what I had hoped to do, but I don't think I'm going to do it because it would take way too long, is I was going to try to do like a rain scene with water coming, with rain coming down. But I don't think that'll work. Yeah, I think I'm going to bring back, oh, of course I'm almost out of red, but I'm going to bring some red back into the cheek there. And this is the nice thing about acrylic paints is you can layer the paint and fix any mistakes you made. I see some thumbs up. Thank you very much. I'm not going to do a whole lot more painting on this, at least not on video, but I am going to outline a few things here. Bring in some of those darker tones again. And something I have noticed with a fairly regular basis is that Daredevil or Matt Murdock tends to have a cleft chin on a regular basis. Ben Affleck has one. I don't know. I can't remember if Charlie Cox does or not. In the comics, Matt Murdock has one. Actually, I might not even do it. Well, yeah, I'll do an outline. But I might do it differently. Ooh, these Copic markers are stronger than I remember. Oh, that looks wonky. Shouldn't have done that. Oh boy, does that look weird now. So what this tells me is I need to darken some of the skin tones in here after I messed up the outline of the face here. It's a little bit too strong. Even worse on the screen there, doesn't it? Tom Luth, if you're still here, turn your face, divert your eyes. I don't want you to see how horrible this is turning out. Tom Luth is a professional comic book colorist and artist. So I think it's great that he's here, but at the same time, I'm pretty damn embarrassed at how this is turning out. Okay, I'm starting to see what I need to do. Looks really odd. Now, at this point, what I actually could do is, which I won't do now because it's, you know, an hour after I started, is I can add some dark background to take away from this hard, dark edge here. So I just made it way too thick. Let me see what happens if I add. It doesn't really do anything. Just adding a little bit of black pen to it. I think one of the things that happens, I got a little too cocky. You guys, a little bit careless. Ooh, some of the paint's still wet. Fantastic. Did not. When I want it to dry fast, it doesn't. When I want it to dry slow, of course it doesn't. Oh, that's looking a little bit better in that area. Oh. Zooks. I grabbed the wrong size pen. It's not even that late and I'm tired. Apparently I'm feeling a little punchy. Five of Stanuary 2019. All right. Well, at this point, this, in actuality, it does look better in person than it does on the screen. Thank goodness. But I think that's it for tonight. I hope you enjoyed yourselves. Those of you who might still be here, for the finished piece, I'll probably post it tomorrow after everything's dry. So have yourselves a good night, and thanks for coming by.